One of our preferred Android smartwatches, the Galaxy Watch 7 stands out for its robust construction and outstanding capabilities. The wearable suffers from weak security-related software support and erratic battery life, hence it is far from flawless. With the Galaxy Watch 8 expected to arrive in a few months, here is my wish list of all the tweaks and enhancements I hope Samsung to do with its next wearable. 1. Enhanced exhibition size. The Watch 7 40mm with a slimmer look features a 1.31-inch circular display, while the 44mm model has a 1.47-inch screen. Though large, Samsung should learn from Apple and move to a larger Galaxy Watch 8 case. This would provide more space for a bigger battery and display, therefore extending battery life. Comparatively, the Apple Watch Series 10 comes in 42mm and 46mm models. The latter has a nearly 2-inch screen. Samsung may potentially utilize the extra internal capacity to get the Galaxy Watch 8 smaller. This would complement the larger shell to keep the watch's proportions in control and give it a sleeker appearance. 2. Regular security patches. Time to enhance your software update approach. Samsung does a wonderful job upgrading its Galaxy phones to the newest monthly security patch available. Still, this same advantage does not transfer over to its Galaxy Watch collection. Since its introduction in July 2024, the Galaxy Watch 7 has only gotten a couple of upgrades. Unlike Galaxy phones, it does not get monthly security fixes. The watch still runs the November 2024 security patch. Samsung handed out an upgrade in early 2025, but it just concentrated on squashing few issues and did not boost the security patch to a newer version. With the Galaxy Watch 8, Samsung has to step up and give the same level of support as its smartphones by giving out monthly security fixes for its future wearable. If not regularly, it should deliver one security patch per quarter. The business performs a wonderful job of pushing out feature-rich upgrades to its Galaxy Watch series, being the first to deliver a new Wear OS version to them. So, there's no reason it cannot do better and deliver consistent security fixes. While doing it, Samsung could also give out updates for the LTE form of the Galaxy Watch 8 alongside the ordinary Bluetooth version. That's not the case with the Galaxy Watch 7 and its predecessor. The LTE versions receive a software upgrade weeks or months after the Bluetooth model. 3. Bring back the actual rotating bezel. Nothing beats the rotating bezel. Samsung abandoned the classic model with its actual rotating bezel with the Galaxy Watch 7. It replaced it with a touch bezel, which works as a digital joystick for moving and scrolling across the UI. However, this touch bezel does not give the same experience as the actual spinning bezel on the Galaxy Watch 6 Classic. The latter makes navigating through lists and the app drawer a snap, while offering a sense that a touch bezel cannot equal. The actual rotating bezel was one of the particular assets of Samsung's smartwatch series. The business should revert to its former approach and introduce the Galaxy Watch 8 Classic with a rotating bezel. This manner, it can cater to both groups of customers, those who want the physical bezel and those who enjoy the touch bezel. 4. Faster charging speed. Quick charging is more crucial on wearables than on phones. Samsung advises using a 15-watt charger to quickly charge the Galaxy Watch 7. The watch also includes with a new charging puck, which is necessary owing to a change in the glass back design. Despite all this, the Galaxy Watch 7 takes about 85 to 90 minutes for a full charge. A 30-minute charge will only fill up the battery to 45%. That's horribly sluggish compared to several of our favorite Android smartwatches. For contrast, the Google Pixel Watch 3 takes an hour to charge its empty battery to full. More significantly, it can charge up to 80% in 35 minutes. Samsung has to do better with the Galaxy Watch 8. I hope it may shorten the 80% top-up time to roughly 35 to 40 minutes. That would be in line with the competition and make rapid recharges more helpful. 5. Reliable battery life. Live up to the statements you make. On paper, the Galaxy Watch 7 checks all the criteria to guarantee a long battery life. The watch uses a powerful new 3-in-1 Exynos W1000 CPU, along with a 300 mAh battery on the 40mm model and a 425 mAh battery on the 44mm edition. Yet, if user complaints are anything to go by, Samsung's 2024 wearable has variable battery life. The business gave out an update weeks after the watch's introduction to fix the first battery depletion concerns. But if reviews on Reddit are anything to go by, many users still receive terrible battery life on their machines. The problem is especially obvious on the 40mm edition of the Galaxy Watch 7, which arrives with a rather modest 300mAh capacity. With the Galaxy Watch 8, Samsung should concentrate on giving a more stable and constant battery life, like the Apple Watch and Google Pixel Watch. A longer battery life is not required, however, it would be pleasant. More significantly, if the business promises the Watch 7 can last 24 hours on a full charge, it should live up to that promise regularly. 6. Wireless PowerShare support, a distinctive strength of Samsung's previous Galaxy Watches. Samsung moved to a new bioactive sensor on the Galaxy Watch 7, touting a 30% boost in health monitoring accuracy. However, a side consequence of this decision was the business had to modify the form of the glass back, increasing the distance between the wireless charging coil and the wireless charger. As a consequence, the Galaxy Watch 7 does not support wireless PowerShare, a function that enables earlier Galaxy Watch models to be wirelessly charged using a Galaxy phone. The poor charging pace makes it less suitable for regular usage. However, wireless PowerShare was a godsend when traveling, guaranteeing you could keep your watch fueled even when you did not have access to its charging puck. Wireless PowerShare was also unique to Samsung's ecosystem, since no other Android wristwatch or even the Apple Watch provided a comparable capability. Despite its limited usage, I hope Samsung brings back wireless PowerShare with the Galaxy Watch 8. Perhaps the business can discover a method to leverage the magnets on Qi2 or Qi2 ready cases to allow the watch to connect to the back of its Galaxy phones magnetically. This would enhance the experience of utilizing the function by allowing a secure connection for more efficient power transmission. Samsung played a vital role in rejuvenating Wear OS with its Galaxy Watch series. It made all the appropriate internal enhancements with the Galaxy Watch 7, moving to a speedier and more efficient 3-nanometer processor and a more precise health sensor. With the next Galaxy Watch 8, the firm has to build on these innovations and overcome the limitations of its 2024 wearable to give an even better experience. Many of you would desire for Samsung to integrate more sophisticated health capabilities, including blood sugar monitoring, on the Galaxy Watch 8. However, I'd rather see the business concentrate on the aforementioned usability enhancements, since Samsung's track record shows its early implementation of new features may not be faultless. When the Samsung Galaxy Watch 7 was launched last summer, my instant thinking was, I wonder what happened to all those promised advancements that didn't come to fruition. Well, dear reader, it's time to dust off the Galaxy Watch 7 rumors and reapply them to Samsung's next-gen wristwatch, the Galaxy Watch 8. There are three especially tasty nuggets of speculative data around the impending Galaxy wristwatch, scheduled to arrive summer 2025, one more remarkable than the other. It seems like every incoming smartwatch model, including both the Apple Watch 11 and Ultra 3, has at least one leak or rumor pointing to a switch away from OLED to micro-LED, and the Galaxy Watch 8 is no exception. I've written multiple times on the advantages of micro-LED compared to OLED, the most prominent being far higher energy efficiency, but increased resolution, brightness, and saturation are all possibly on tap. The Samsung Galaxy Watch Ultra is the brand's first wearable in many years to boast a squarish casing. Is Samsung moving too far into Apple's territory? Galaxy Watch 8 speculations hint that the Ultra may not be the only Samsung wristwatch to boast an angular appearance. I have conflicting sentiments about this relocation. As someone who analyzes smartwatches for a career, I have no particular preference for square versus round casings. I find both comparably comfortable. Of course, a square casing makes it more evident you're carrying a little computer on your wrist than a rounder one if that sort of thing matters to you. Similar to micro-LED updates, it appears like every single smart wearables maker is striving to figure out non-invasive blood glucose monitoring via the wrist, a breakthrough that would make controlling diabetes much simpler. And there's reason to suppose that Samsung may beat its competitors, particularly Apple, to the punch with blood glucose monitoring in a wristwatch. I first projected that we'd receive the groundbreaking functionality in the gadget which ended up becoming the Galaxy Watch Ultra. Now, I'm cautiously hopeful that it will launch on the Galaxy Watch 8. With the most prominent Samsung Galaxy Watch 8 speculations so far, out of the way, it's time to dream big and speak about my hopes and aspirations for the Galaxy Watch 8. Having evaluated both the Galaxy Watch 7 and Google Pixel Watch 3, one area Google surpasses Samsung is in battery life, notably for the bigger 45mm Pixel Watch 3. My challenge to Samsung: replicate that device's 48-hour battery life statistic with the next-gen XL Galaxy Watch model. Speaking of the big boy, I'd like to see Samsung boost the size of the Galaxy Watch 8 from 44mm to 46mm to match the Apple Watch 10 and separate it from Google's 45mm XL. Finally, for all my fellow fidgeters out there, Samsung, please bring back the classic-style clicky bezel. It's both functional and incredibly soothing to futz with. What do you wish to see in the Samsung Galaxy Watch 8? Let me know in the comments below. So that's it for today's video. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more tech news and updates.